Hello everyone, I'm back and here to react to Doctor Who Season 10, Episode 9. So let's begin.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Sorry, I could never resist a countdown.
Who the hell are you?
Friendly aliens. Don't mind us. Just a day out for the kids.
It's from the chief.
Is it? Oh, yes, that's right. Authorizing us to go anywhere we please. So... Valkyrie.
So what? Valkyrie is probing the Martian ice caps with a new kind of camera aboard. It uses a different spectrum to see under the poles and beam back pictures.
Last time we did the ice caps on Mars, Mars and ice caps have never been good. Okay. Won't save the queen.
Empress of Mars.
Back to Mars.
Mars, 1881, or thereabouts. According to the TARDIS, that's when the message was made. Though we may be a bit early.
Maybe someone's been messing around with time. Like in The Terminator.
The Terminator?
It's a movie.
Have you not seen it?
I'm a very busy man.
Of all the movies.
Got killer robots.
Oh, I'll put you on the list.
Look, if there's fire,
there's oxygen.
The oxygen.
Wait,
no! Okay.
I'll go first.
What are you doing?
Fire oxygen. Basic physics, isn't it?
Could have been basic death.
Wait, I mean, he's not human.
Indigenous Martians were superb engineers. Mind you, there's a lot here that doesn't make sense.
This is 1881.
What's the underground tunnels in the thing?
What?
It's a movie.
Have you not seen that either? Really? Good lord, you need to watch more human movies. Bill! Ow.
Bill!
Hang on. We'll find a way down. Go back to the TARDIS. Get ropes.
Whoa, whoa, girl, what are you doing? Girl, what are you doing? That's not what's supposed to be doing.
Sasha, what the hell are you doing?
You did not just... Sexy, what are you doing? I'm thinking badly. I'm thinking very badly.
I say, no, I'm expecting company.
What are you doing?
This creature is no threat. He may look like a monster to you.
I wasn't talking to you. You all right, Friday? Who are you? What the damn are you doing here?
What?
Well, I could ask you the same question.
Missy? Oh, not careful.
Miss?
was wondering if I could ask for your help. I need to get to Mars. I need to get back to Mars, in fact. And it's a little bit urgent. Only the TARDIS is acting up. I was wondering if you could tell me how to fix...
Of course I can.
Oh, right. Oh, thank you.
It's probably easier if I just show you.
Oh.
I found Friday here on board, in a sort of coma, half dead.
Why do you call him that?
Man Friday? Hasn't worked with some Crusoe. So, according to this, you've been on board Friday's ship the whole time.
Yes, that we were.
Huh.
That's us. Yes, it's right. On his ship.
Well, I suppose it was pretty roomy, what?
It was. Yes, wasn't it?
So, yes, you found a ship.
But the whole, you know, I mean, getting on board, I mean, that's all. It's all a bit hazy. Maybe you could tell us everything.
Yes, well, after I woke him up, Friday asked for my help.
To repair his spaceship.
Yes, and to bring him home.
In return. For what?
He promised us gemstones, you see? Silver, gold, the treasure beyond our wildest dreams.
That's why you helped him come home. To claim Mars in the name of Queen Victoria. To loot it of its riches.
Ah! Hey!
The Red Planet's happy.
It's her! Oh my god!
You know what Friday is then?
Yep.
I swear.
And they're the proper Martians, right? They belong here.
Yes. The indigenous species, an ancient reptilian race, they built themselves a sort of biomechanical armor for protection. The creature within is at one with its counterpace. The Ice Warriors. They could build a city out of the sand. Entrench the snows of Mars with his blood. They could slaughter whole civilizations, yet weep the crushing of a flower.
Like Vikings.
Yes. Yes, very much.
Yeah. Kirk Douglas and Tony Curtis. Oh, the theme tune is amazing. There's this brilliant bit where his eye gets gouged out.
Spoilers, Bill. Spoilers.
Why do you really come back? I'm old and tired and spent.
For old and tired, you still have good reflexes.
You must come at once, sir. The Gargantua. She's uncovered something.
Good Lord.
Looks like old Friday came good after all.
Oh, that's beautiful. Why is it a tomb?
Not just any tomb. This is the tomb of ice cream. Sometimes part of a complex hibernation system.
Sergeant Major, get these civilians out of here.
No, Carl! Friday's been using you all along. His aim was to get back to Mars and find his queen.
Nonsense. He was leading us to the riches he promised us.
What riches? After months?
The sooner you get off this planet, the better.
Don't belong. We're British. Mars is part of the Empire now.
I'm betting that's an Ice Warrior right there. Like, it's not inside, it's there. It's a rupee. It's a blue rupee. Hello, girl.
I honor thee, Eraxa, my empress, my queen. We have slept longer than anticipated. By my calculations, Majesty, we have slept for 5,000 years.
Wow. She is awake. Good, okay, maybe we get a chance. Not gonna happen, but we're gonna get a chance.
Both surrounded by noisy males. I would value your opinion.
They're not lying to you. There's no need for anyone else to die today. The human saved his life.
Is this true?
His cryogenic cell was damaged. They saved him.
Engage him.
It is necessary to dissemble, Majesty. I thought only of your resurrection. It was a tactical decision.
An Ice Warrior's duty is to command.
Alexa, listen to me. The Mars you rule is gone. But don't let it end this way.
Fight this for the future, not a dead past.
No!
Majesty, are you alright?
You ask for mercy for these creatures.
You did.
Then I grant it.
Oh.
Thank you.
That is a really good costume.
Listen to me, men. The colonel is not what he appears.
The hero of his uncle Lana. Show them your famous
Show them.
The mark of a rogue.
While you were fighting the queen and country, the colonel here was dancing the Newgate polka. This is the mark of the rogue that failed to hang him for desertion.
Look, it doesn't matter who's in charge of your stupid expedition.
Let's take a chance against the ice fires.
What are two of them?
There'll be more, you idiot. The hive is active. Don't you see? They'll do anything to defend their home planet.
Well, I dare say the British Army is more than a match for a bunch of upright crocodiles.
Sergeant Major! Assuming command. Take the colonel and put him in the brig.
Oh, and for the last time, get these wretched people out of my sight.
Put them in the brig, too.
There's no room for civilians here.
Carry on, Sergeant Major.
Wood?
There's no setting for wood. Why is there still no setting for wood?
Are you serious?
Yes, of course I've got a plan. Of all plans. I'm made of plans.
Well, you seem to know a lot about most things.
Well, whistle, please.
You speak for yourself.
What?
A woman in the police force.
Listen. Yeah? I'm going to make allowances for your Victorian attitude because... Well, you actually are... But anyway, is it true? You deserted? Why?
Cowardice. So look, I thought I had it in me to command as possible when push came to shove. I had it planted. Deserted my post.
Always liked the colonel, I did. Seemed a decent chap.
Must take orders from the captain, that son.
Where are you getting your water?
Sir.
Lovely, Sarge. This is something to tell your kids. I mean, more chance.
You just fight.
Friday? Friday.
Choice on the way. You see, I suddenly remembered I need a bit of a hand getting that bloody shit off the ground.
Hold on. Gentlemen, it's been a privilege, however brief, to command you, but
all good things come to an end.
I
think you'll find, Captain, that I'm in command here.
Wow.
You sacrificed one of your own without tactical advantage.
No, I didn't sacrifice him. I executed him.
Do you now expect your life to be spared?
No. I expect it to be taken. And I give it willingly.
Stop it.
Some time ago, I was hanged for cowardice. The execution took longer than expected, and I fear I have not used my time well. I should be happy for you to complete the work they failed to do so long. I have a request, if that may be permitted.
Speak!
That man was not one of us. Please do not judge mankind by his cruelty, or indeed by my cowardice. Spare my friends and my world.
Your request does you credit, soldier. It will be considered.
God save the Queen!
God save the Queen!
You will die with honor.
Thank you. You don't know what that means.
Thank you. But not today. In battle, soldier, to die in battle is the way of the warrior. Pledge your allegiance to me and my world, and I will ensure you have the opportunity.
My life and my service are yours. To the end.
To the death, my friend. To the death.
You knew that would happen.
In fact, this might be the beginning of the Martian Golden Age.
Are you receiving us? Mars, are you receiving?
This is Iraxa, Queen Empress of Mars.
Ah, excellent. We have received details of your situation. We would be happy to send a fleet to your aid at once. A physical marker of some sort would be appreciated to guide our ships.
To whom am I speaking?
This is Alpha Centauri. Welcome to the universe.
You gonna be okay?
Well, that's twice I've been executed. Whatever happens now is gonna be better than I expected. There's nothing for me back on Earth, and to help forge a new world, well, that will be my privilege. Seems a shame that no one back on Earth will ever know that we got it. But I will be forgotten.
Oh, not quite forgotten, Carl. Someone's got to notice that.
Nice. There she is. Except I think I know who's piloting it this time.
So, what did I miss?
What have you been?
Yeah.
Before you go getting all frowny,
Hello, Missy.
You're right.
What?
The dogs are being sound. Really?
Are you all right?
All right. Well, that was actually a very, very good episode. I actually enjoyed that one a lot. I mean, it's good to see more Ice Warriors. The dilemma of trying to get these two races to work together was very, very, very cool. Yeah, that's just about all I can say. Not much else, except that I really enjoyed this episode. So yeah, Anyway, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Take care, and I'll see you there in the next episode. Bye-bye.